Hi guys, Xanarang here, and I am very angry today. I'm also angry yesterday, mainly because I recorded this video already, and then I had to scrap the recording because my microphone was boosted to 150% or something ridiculous, and everything sounded horrible, and there was a fan blaring the whole time as well, and it all just went completely wrong. But it doesn't matter, because now I'm back with the Community Maps playthrough series. Sorry that it's been a few days. So we got water there, sorry. It's very hot to where I am again, so... Yeah, I'm going to move into three levels that I already recorded, so my reaction to these probably won't be as good as last time, but what I will say is that they're three scenario type levels, and it shouldn't take me too long to get through them and give you a quick rundown of what's going on. This level I'm not going to be playing today, it's called Honey, I Shrunk the Bikers, but I do actually recommend it. The reason I'm not playing it is because it's not very video friendly for various reasons, including that it's quite big and the weapons are a bit scarce and stuff, but I did actually enjoy it. It's a really fun concept that doesn't really exist in the game, or exist on the workshop very much. There's very, very few examples of this big scaling done on, like, real objects. There's a level in the original Dropper that was like that I loved. But, yeah, no one will know what I'm talking about there. I guess I'll begin with Rosie's Diner. I don't know if I'd say I enjoyed this one the most, but I thought the music was brilliant and the gameplay was pretty good. I suppose it's a good thing that I'm re-recording this in some ways, because I actually missed most of the powerful weapons on this level. And I can also walk you through a couple of the things that I found, because there's one, a few references, some good music, you know, a lot of enemies to kill, it's all good, it's all what you want to look for in Paint and Sunred. Sorry if I've got my, like, starting frame rate that drops, and then after a few seconds it should recover. But anyway, it's the Blue Swallow Motel, there's vacancies, there's 100% refrigerated air, which sounds like a sign you might get in jazz punk or something, which is, if you've played that game, it's one of my favourite ever. We've got delicious at home in Rosie's Diner. Delicious. I didn't read that correctly at all, but whatever. There's also a shotgun up here that I found pretty quickly and get to the back kitchen. I'm going to get copy claimed to hell on this video, so I'm not going to worry too much about the music anyway. It's the DeLorean, by the way. This is very 80s, which I love about this level. I wasn't around in the 80s, I'm afraid to say, but I do love it. I wish I was. Very, very cool prefab. Whoever made this, you're an absolute legend. Very, very good job on that. I'm going to move over to the lobby to investigate what's going on. It is, of course, a motel and a diner. Got the katana boss who works here. I'm not sure how he has the time, but maybe this is how he made his millions. We've got a typically broken Paint the Sand Red door here. Can we get someone to walk into it again? Probably not. Can I teleport up with it? Eh, kind of. Typically broken, as I say. We've got this yellow key that I didn't really appreciate the significance of last time. I couldn't find anything the red key did, but I'm assuming he'll attack me now if I jump over the counter. Yes. And these huge-handed guards are going to be a bit of a problem. We do have this banger song, though, by Blondie, which is good in the background while we do some fighting. Until, of course, I run into a reference and then it changes the sound effect, which I do love, by the way. It's great that it has, like, procedural music. You don't see that too much, except for in, I guess, sort of very cinematic levels. And I suppose that that's the best use of it is probably in those levels. But if you do it correctly, it's great in these levels. Anyway, everyone in here, very canonical Paint the Town Red, had everyone beating each other up. Let's see, these are all, by the way, great skin packs. Very, very smooth. Crisp, very well made indeed. And yeah, we'll get some killing. It all works quite well together. It all feels very 80s. Of course, Biker Bar, I believe, takes place in the 80s. With the good old... Actually, maybe it takes place in the 90s. I'm not sure. But I know that disco takes place in the 70s, and these characters are out of disco, more or less. So that's quite a nice progression there. There was an MP5 somewhere I need to go and find before going and getting the super good weapons that I had last time. Now, where could that be? I don't know. Maybe it was in the kitchen back here somewhere. I wouldn't specifically look for it for too long, but yeah. Got a broom, that'll do. That'll do very nicely. There's a machete up there. We can kill... can we get the biker boss with it? I always call him Katana Boss there. Good question for the comment section. Do you prefer Biker Boss or Katana Boss? Leave it below. Our big debate that's gone on the network for some time. So there we are. So I've had a little scrap in there. Police aren't really doing anything. Not very big law enforcement. This is all nice. It's all pink mist. Kind of a weird choice, but it works pretty well with this level, I guess. It's not hugely immersive, but it is quite a nice scenario. I like it a lot. This row doesn't feel too ridiculous or anything like that. The car prefabs are all pretty good. I mean, there's nothing really to complain about, which is the great part. It's a typical motel room. We've got light, by the way, I should say. Robocop and Terminator, if that is who they are. I hope so, I'm not getting that wrong. Robocop, the Terminator, Batman, Captain Crook and Darth Vader, Lohan, Superman, every single Power Ranger, and then it goes on and on. Yeah, I'm not going to sing the whole song for you guys, but whatever. You know what I'm talking about. We've got ourselves a rifle in our room and a 1911. Let's see what we can do with this. Very good music. Walk along the razor edge. Very, very good music that I obviously will not continue to sing along to, but whatever. Very, very good music that is very 80s indeed, and even before the 80s, of course. With this. I mean, maybe I'm getting that totally wrong, but the DeLorean is very 80s. Some of the music is quite 70s, a lot of the style, it could be considered both. I just like it, regardless. Won't think too much about that. Get everyone down. I'm using this super efficient, not very fun technique. Let's just miss the last bullets. Apparently I was going to say spray, but I only had a few left. Let's grab ourselves another pistol and see what we can do. Actually, do I have any... No one else is up here. Right, hang on. Can I shockwave people through this window? Get a nice bird's eye view of it. Yes, a lot of destruction in there. Oh, brilliant. They're getting stuck on the light fixtures and everything. It's all going brilliantly well. Let's see if we can get ourselves a pistol up here. Let's go grab it. Just going to listen to the Scarface soundtrack for a second. If that's what this is. Oh, an awful shot, aren't I? I really am useless at using guns in this. Because the sensitivity you need to do well with guns in this is quite different to the sensitivity you need to speedrun with melee weapons in this. In my opinion, at least on my configuration. There's a good taser, I just found that by accident. Genuinely didn't know about that before. But as I say, if you just skipped to this point of the video or you didn't see the start, yeah, basically, I've already recorded this video. So I know where a few things are, but I'm actually not doing as well as I was last time. I've lost a lot of health. Can we get some knives? A few things on the shelf. I'm really looking for weapons, but I know there are a lot, which is actually a good feature of this level. This is kind of busted, but... whoa, are you going in the walls? That doesn't seem completely fixed, mapmaker. No, there's probably nothing you can do about that, relatively speaking. Can we get ourselves another weapon of some kind? It's a bottle, that'll do. That'll do very well. I knocked his whole arm off with one bottle hit there. That didn't... Very destructive. Does he have a taser? No, it's just a drinking glass. I feel like the police improvise a little bit too much in this game. They never seem to go for the optimal weapon, but there we are. Good kick to the face there. Can we get any more weapons in reception? That's a good idea. Maybe behind the counter. Yes, the katana. This is what I used last time. I forgot about it until just now. We've got ourselves the katana boss here. His legs are gone. His body is being cut away. Typical katana boss fashion. He's now done for. Perfect. I knew it was about then. Ooh, got a sneaky hit on me there with a pot. Very lucky indeed. I've always thought it'd be funny if we could have a colander or a helmet or a pot helmet in this game. It'd be great. The possibilities are virtually endless. But again, that's just because I like jazz punk. Boom. Bang. If you like retrofuturism, give this video a thumbs up and then go and download the map. It's in the description below. Maybe it doesn't cycle the music and maybe it's just location-based, but whatever. Either way, I enjoyed them. Got ourselves another broom. That was a pretty satisfying hit there. Ooh, that was very good as well. This is the kind of level where the environment really works brilliantly with the people, and it's all fantastic. I've got myself... Okay, I'm not sure why this pair of nunchucks is there. That's good. The AI isn't getting stuck on these chairs particularly. Look at this. I'm going to see if this guy can get off. Can he get off? Oh, come on. Now I've piped it up. Damn it, I got killed. I saw him coming. I didn't think he would hit me with such a lunge. That's my fault anyway. Let me get back to where I was before, guys. Let's redo that gun segment in a little bit more of a fun sense. I think that wasn't good enough. Can we get into this bathroom? I didn't see that particularly. This is a... Well, I mean, there's nothing else particularly to say about the motel except that this is a pretty good prefab. This is a very nice prefab. I like that a lot. This almost feels like it could be in a scenario. It's one of those ones where it juts out in just the right kind of way. Unfortunately, I did speedrun the start of this because I just wanted to get back to my point as quickly as possible. So I just use the katana leg slice strap, which if you haven't seen before, check out a disco speedrun of this game. It takes about 40 seconds. Kind of unbelievable, isn't it? What else we got in here? Should we use a bit of smite? Nah, it's not as fun as shockwaves, I don't think, because it's just, you don't kill anyone with it. Really is a bit of a waste of your time. Okay, baseball bat. I wasn't expecting that particularly, but let's use it. Police, again, improvising with their fists rather than, you know, guns and or taser weapons. Got ourselves a cleaver, that'll do. It's got a tray, this chef, or a plate rather, which means it's no good. Got ourselves a few things here, there's a glass, another steak. What else have we got going on around here? There's a few bottles. I guess this is probably a level that's a lot more fun casually rather than at this kind of high speed level that I'm trying to play it at and failing. What else we got? Women's, nothing. Men's, which I already checked, nothing. Except that going through... This is also good. Because I'll comment on this later in another level that I'm going to bring up, but there are some levels like these are just really, they put a lot of thought into the combat area, and the flooring is wide enough that you're not suffocating with the AI everywhere. And there are a lot of levels like that, I must say, that are being made, and some of them are just so good, like this one, that they can actually consider that. I mean, I'm not a map maker, I have no place commenting on this, but that's just something I see in a lot of maps, and I'm pleased to have it resolved whenever possible. I'm still not sure what happened to the MP5 that I had at one point on this map. I don't really know where it is. I mean, I say these people don't get stuck on the tables, they basically just jump off of them. By the way, these lights are fantastic, I like them a lot. This is the way they hang from the ceiling. There's a place a bit like this near me, but I don't go there very much. In real life, that is. So let's get the shotgun from this van and see if there's anyone else mooching around the hotel that I can take out and then just deal with the diner. I don't think there is. I think I got pretty much everyone. Unless they're in my room, not really. I don't know if it is my room. I think I just stole the key, to be honest. Harpoon gun over here, right? That'll be good. Right, let's throw this over to there then. Take this harpoon gun. There's a spiked bat there as well. Very good. A lot of options, clearly. So you can get satisfying leg kill with harpoon gun. Making the same mistake. Biker boss is back for more. Take him down, lads. Let's get people away from this corner a little bit, shall we? I think it's mainly my shockwaves, actually, that have been screwing up the AI pathfinding. Not the level's fault, as I should say. And I'm not sure that anyone would actually be stuck on here. It's like, it's not like you wouldn't be able to find them, lads. Get a few more good hits in there. Also, it's lovely the windows are being painted a good shade of red. I always like that transparency when it gets painted because, it doesn't work from one side, so it's always good fun. It's all good. All good. I didn't kill the Katana boss yet, actually, which might be a bit of an issue. Maybe I'll use Berserk to finish him off. 9 left, as I expected to get roughly with that blast. That was a good couple more kills there. Actually, let's just get the Katana boss normally. Berserk is just too easy. Not that I'm trying to make this harder particularly, but I think I will. In the last moments, you always want to do that. Just make it more fun. Because it's been a great experience, and you're probably not going to come back to the level for a while. Why does he lose interest in you, this goddamn Katana boss? 0 out of 10. Would not care. No more weapons behind the counter. Slightly surprising. We got a plate. Be very afraid. Did nothing. Of course it didn't. Should I go for that spike back, perhaps? I mean, it's not very many... Not much call for it left in the level, but we might as well, mightn't we? Use all the weapons possible. Very good song, as I keep saying. Damn it. Let's go and get it again. Can I get a trick shot from someone? Ooh, it was a good shot. Didn't think that would have hit him at all. Call me. Let's do... And he's gone, and his body broke in half. And can I get a sick shot on this guy? Yes, that was pretty good. Pretty satisfied with that. And then we leave on the bus. The motel has been decimated. This screen is a bit weird. I was confused by that, but you might listen. If you listen carefully, more good music. How about that? It's Africa. I'm not going to stay here the whole duration of play, though. But yeah, that's, as you can see, very, very well-made level indeed. I'm going to move on quickly enough, though, because I want to get through two more scenario-type levels today. Second one is Hollow No Graffiti Office. Now, this level, made by Whamcrash, very good map maker. I've shown lots of maps on the channel already. Very, very talented in many areas, because, as I was just saying, adapted for scenario combat, adapted for AI combat, nothing feels too cramped or too open. It's very well done for that sense. But obviously there are some maps that are references or storytelling or cinematic, and that's where you don't necessarily have the best combat. But it's alright there. Didn't pick up on this last time, but yes, I'll immediately mention no more bikers, no more disco. Very, very cool posters. I love both of them a lot. And I didn't mention it particularly, and there's also a nice Paint the Sand Red poster. Excuse me. This is a very good level because it is a recreation, or a very accurate recreation, I am told, of the Hololive offices, which you can read about here. I'll very quickly run down. It's an agency of virtual YouTubers created by Cover Corp, Japanese-based idol corporation that recruits idol talent, and it's similar to what other streamers mostly do. They usually do gaming, chatting, and or karaoke streams, apparently. I don't know very much at all about this. I know about what's on this board. more or less, and then I hear people online complaining about it. And if you didn't like this level because it's Hololive, then shut up, because not only are we killing everyone, it's a really good, well-made level for this game. I'm going to kill some people now and get some detail later. All of these names you're seeing on the boards on the side are people who either work here or are just like names within the brand. Like this is presumably not a real name, obviously. Iris or Iris. Very sick name, but not quite right. We've got a Smite energy drink. Very cool poster there. Let's run down some more posters. There's also a brilliant, I should say, brought to you by Coco Momo Chocolates, cookie station or chocolate station that heals you if I get super low, which I will because I always fail at good levels. No, no, I'm just joking. I never fail except for when I do in most videos. The thing is, a lot of the levels are played blind in this game, so I will generally fail once or twice because I have no idea what I'm doing. And that's just because I'm trying to talk about everything whilst playing. I think by myself I'd probably be okay. Or it would take me a long time, but yeah. Point is, I'm not brilliant at this. Expect a few failures. There is so much detail here that I'm never going to be able to cover it. Got Minato Aqua. Not sure what that is. It's more people, I guess. I'm not going to run down all those names, but there are some honourable mentions. Salute. Worth it. There's DDLC on the computer, of course, with a knife behind it. Hopefully not a reference to Yuri. Good old storage room. There's lots and lots and lots of available weapons. And there's an AI staircase for the NPCs. Sorry, NPC staircase that the NPCs can access that the player can't, which is a really good idea. I don't see that at all on levels because they can't use the elevator very easily, of course, because it's operated by buttons. So yeah, you get a brilliant little AI, it's NPC elevator or stair access, which gets them to the other floors. And there are two more floors, I should say. Very, very detailed, cool map. Bailey's Irish Cream. It's not like Erdenbrew, it's Bailey. Very good. There's also a dead meat poster somewhere here. What am I talking about? Here it is. Rude beer. Taste of pure rudeness. Like root beer, but not. You get it? Also, when I was testing this map, I suggested lowering the windows, and that's so we can have fun activities like this. Now, they're gone, because there's a kill box down there. But yes, having the windows like this means we can get some fantastic clips and some fantastic destruction going on. A few chefs that are naturally, because it's a scenario, oblivious to what's going on. Nice lambda symbol. I still don't know if that's because Wham's a fan of Half-Life or just because it's a cool looking symbol. I assume it's probably a bit of both. But yes, got a few crystal shards in the fridge. I suppose they're meant to be like sticks of celery or whatever they eat here. No idea. But there's a nice rock-on poster, Wham Crush, which is obligatory at this point. It actually works, apparently, but I've got too many people following me. You can get like a keg of it in the bottom here if you press the buttons correctly. There we go, got one. And there's also a tire iron on top of it, because there always is. And that is just something that I've come to accept in this game. It's like the rule of the internet, rule of paint the sand red, that there will be a tire iron on top of the Wham Crush machine. And these great posters from Biker Bar, which I love as well. It's just very little to complain about. Also, I must say while I'm here, because I didn't say this particularly in a lot of detail last time, this character pack, the people I'm killing here, really well made. Like, it's so detailed, so crisp. Just like the last one. And it's got this rather ghostly effect where people have this listless expression when they've been killed. On their eyes, if they still have eyes, I should say. Which is so unusual to see in this game. You tend to get people with their eyes closed or their eyes just gone. This listless expression is quite haunting and quite terrifying in a cool way. It is a little weird that they all have this very manly voice, while a lot of these people clearly are female. But not a lot, it's just that there are a number who clearly are. Oh well. Might as well continue like this. Bathrooms, everyone cleared out of here? Presumably, yes. Yeah, I'd say so. Actually, these are showers, sorry, not bathroom. The one on the other side is. Got everyone on this floor, mostly. The NPC stairs are bringing some more people up, though, clearly. So let's get out of here and move up to the next floor. And there is a nice reference here to Teldrassil Q, which is another amazing level by Wham Crash, which you should type in and download now, because it's a great adventure. If this kind of scenario level isn't for you, I'm sure that will be. What else we got here? And if that isn't enough, try this one. Extra Rude Beer. It's actually a really funny poster. I believe that Yakuza Makitsune is involved in it somehow, so thanks to him for that weirdly prominent reference. I don't know why it's being used so much, but I see it quite a lot of the time. This is Hakos Bales. I'm not sure who that is. But we can open and close these windows at a whim. It's great. Look at this. Look at that. We can have them partly open, partly not. If they did open from the top, you could have like a smaller gap. That would be pointless. I mean, it's great that they open at all, really. I can't complain at all about that. This is another good level that I did on stream, but the VOD is gone because Twitch is really good at saving VODs. Except it was entirely my fault, and I'm not sure I'm complaining to Twitch. What else we got here? A-chan's office. And there's a lot of names there that are presumably credits. This is a level that is kind of lost on me, I must say, just because I don't understand the references at all. That was a fucking hilarious death. What happened there? I forgot about this person with a gun completely, but yeah, there's someone with a gun. Might have a heal to avoid them. They got a knife on their desk. Quick throw to the head. Knife to the head. You were dead before you hit the floor. Except they are strangely resilient. But yes, this level is quite lost on me because I don't understand a lot of the references. If you do know about Hololive and have seen this kind of space, please check out this level. I'm sure you'll enjoy it a lot more than I am. And I'm enjoying it a lot. One of the top levels I've played recently, I'd say. I know a lot of them are, to be honest. I've liked a lot of the levels I've played on this channel just because those are the ones that kind of make it to the channel. If I just find a level that's new on the workshop and it turns out to be a little more than a default room, no. Pointless. But everyone's been beaten to death. I speak too soon. We've got everyone. We didn't get enough people out the window, really. But if you want to keep doing that yourself, then please check out the level, as I keep suggesting. Part of the reason I don't retry until I get every possible solution of these levels is so you guys can too. I mean, that's a classic excuse. But whatever. It's true. Wait, there was something over here. Yes, the Hololive Error Order. This is a really cool poster. I like this. Not sure if it's actually a technically impressive achievement in the level editor to do this, but it just looks fantastic. Look at that. Look at that text, the effort that must have gone into making that. I just have to appreciate that, it's crazy. Load of things in here that I didn't use at all, because I was too lazy and or didn't remember they were there. We've got ourselves one more bullet, should we shoot it in this person's head? I was hoping they'd go flying, but they didn't. Come on. No, we couldn't make it happen. Oh well. Just check the level out yourself and play it like that. A lot of computer workspace over here as well, a lot of offices that I didn't properly cover. And this person's on PTTR Hub. Odd, isn't it? Got a few weapons up here as well that, again, I didn't use very much of, but I'm hoping that other people can too. Now, I think we leave via a fire escape. On my first attempt, I used a lot more weapons. It's a shame that I simply cannot show you that recording because it's just totally unwatchable. Whoops, I forgot that the elevator is not unilateral. Let's go here and use this one. I think the fire escape's on the bottom floor, at least. It might not be. Is it down here? Yes. Fucking bin in my way. Interesting prop collision there. I got a really funny, I'll try and play this on screen if I can remember, but yeah, I got a really funny character glitch through the floor last time that was absolutely mad, and it'd be quite a shame to lose that. Well, I better move it along to the last level, which there isn't as much to say about, but I did enjoy this one too, because it's called Secluded Swamp by Spurdole and Kingy. And this has a part 2 that has been very recently released, and both parts are already very... the second one's already very popular. This one's also very popular on the workshop, so I was suggested to play it by Yakuza Mikitsi, who I've played a lot of levels of, very talented mapmaker as well. But yeah, this one's very cool. It may not look the most technically impressive with the trees and all of that, but it actually is a blast. The only trouble is, last time I couldn't finish it because I couldn't find an enemy, and I'm pretty convinced what happened is they were either shockwaved totally out of the map or onto one of these trees. Can happen, so I'm not going to use too many shockwaves, if or any at all, if I can help it this time. But this is obviously a place in the Deep South, or the Midwest, or something crazy, where there are these insane racist rednecks with their goddamn Confederate flags. We're gonna take them all down, teach them a lesson. Again, I'm gonna get the fighting started ASAP, because I am pushed for time a little bit on this, because I've had so much fun and taken my time until this point, pretty much. Let's grab ourselves a crowbar and see what we can do. It is obviously a swamp, so there's this very satisfying water texture that you can go through. I mean, isn't that brilliant? I love that in levels like this. Just levels in general, I suppose. I loved it on Chill Shark's Doom level. If you haven't played that, I recommend it too enormously. Because, yeah, it's just a Doom level, but it has this in acid water at one point that is great. These boats are also very cool. I don't think they appear in the scenarios. If it's prefab, well done. They actually don't glitch your character around into infinity. Oh, saying that, they kind of do. I didn't have that problem last time. Maybe it's an issue with my game state. Sorry about that. These logs are surprisingly good prefabs as well, though. Actually, they're much nicer and cleaner than you get in some areas. I remember that. I mean, to save space and to save runtime, you obviously don't want to have incredibly detailed prefabs everywhere. But, you know, it's got to be done sometimes when you can afford to, because there are some levels I've played that are big and interesting and expansive, and then they do have prefabs like that, and they need it, so it's kind of fine. But if you can, detailed prefabs just make the game incredible. You really do. This guy was very strong last time. We've got this nice church convene. The power and reach of Christianity is all but unknown to the wider world. That was a crazy satisfying death. But yes, we're going to get to be with this revolver that I didn't even discover last time. You might not believe it, but that's the first time I've seen that revolver. How is he not dead? You're missing all of your brain, more or less. We get him in the rest of the brain. I don't think that killed him. Yeah, he's still up. That got him. Finish him off with the last bit of my gun handle. So, yeah, there are a lot of these buildings to check out. It actually feels like a proper swamp place. I mean, the lighting's pretty good. I love the lanterns everywhere. That works super well. Although it's a bit hard to tell that I'm in the swamp right now, to be honest. I mean, I've got to go onto this bridge, and then I'm like, oh wait, that was all mud that I've been trudging through. I'm not sure how I can do it at light speed, but whatever. Get ourselves a harpoon here. He's gone, obviously, because, as always, enemies cannot kill enemies. And cannot be killed by enemies. Simply a fact of the game, but yes, hopefully we don't shockwave any enemies onto these trees. Last time I did actually try and venture up there using daggers to climb up the church wall, but it was just too difficult. Isn't it? Using knives and daggers, sorry, not just daggers, that would be silly. I don't know if there are any. Well, did this guy have a knife? I think they did, didn't they? Yes, or a sword even, much nicer. We got ourselves these ninja people who I'm killing now. We shall over by some kind of campfire. Let's see if I can find it, just to show you what that's like as well. But all of this is kind of impressive. Like, it's really nicely put together and doesn't feel like level is too expansive, really. It feels quite manageable, even though it's so open and big, which is very odd. But yeah, very well done on that. And these trucks have their headlights on and they're facing each other. I just love that kind of effect in games. It's great. It's just, isn't that brilliant? With all the reflections coming off the blood. If your computer can run anything like, I don't know what a good benchmark is for this, but my computer has a 1050 and 16 gigs of old RAM, so if you have anything better than that, I suggest checking out this game in general. It's not as intensive as it appears to be. It's not like Teardown, although it is kind of in the same ballpark, to be honest. The main game runs so much better than everything on the workshop, though. It's odd that I guess it's just been perfectly tuned and optimized. Got a surprising amount of people chasing me, though. Let's see if we can deal with them. And go over to that fire that I was ranting and raving about. Where is it? Edge of the map, obviously, is a little unimmersive, but what can you do? It's the swamp, am I right? It is. There's nothing interesting to say about that. There are some cool notes here that I didn't read last time. I found myself deep in an odd community deep in the swamps. They seem to be following leader declaring himself as a prophet. Oh, so it's a cult. It's not actually Christianity. I'm so sorry to everyone. It's a cult. I do apologize, but they are still deserved to be wiped out. Oh god, I love when you throw lanterns. Isn't that just tremendous? We got this jar weapon as well from Saloon that is quite fun. He's got a pot. Superb. Some of these people, I'm afraid they might find me lurking. No, I was very wrong about the community here. They saw me and they took me in, showed me their world, their views. Their father is truly a prophet. Someone worthy of a plaque of patriotism, unlike the sinful politicians outside. Yep, so it's a cult. It's a cult community. It's horrifying and we're going to kill everyone immediately. It cannot persist. I shall follow father's word and live like a true God-fearing American should. God bless. Oh, I'm not sure if they should have used that, but oh well. God bless. I think I've been sent by him too, to be honest. To kill the pretender. I'm like the cultist in Skyrim come to kill the dragonborn. This is a satisfying prefab that I'm going to comment on because I did last time. Look at this Bible. It's so neat and tidy and lovely. It's like a book. It's a book prefab, obviously. But book prefabs are just lovely in this game. I love them. I love a lot of prefabs in this game, actually, to be fair, but this one is just very clean, I like it a lot, and yeah, it's all very well put together, this map, as I keep saying. Some of the stuff you can't move, like this bucket and mop, because it would be, I don't know, maybe because it's not because it's too overpowered, maybe it would be detrimental to the gameplay. This guy is just, I don't know what he's fighting thin air, fighting a bee or a moth in the swamp, perhaps? This house was the most impressive, I suppose, because it has this game-hunting bear on the wall and a telephone and all these amazing prefabs. This stove is presumably from something in the main game, I guess. But yeah, we're getting all of them. Double barrel, let's see what we can do with this. There's a true God-fearing American up here, and he's in bits. Unfortunate that, isn't it? Got ourselves another Confederate flag, unacceptable. I don't know if that guy died, I kind of shot him in the back. That was like Finn in Force Awakens, if you've seen that. Which is a disaster, by the way. Okay, I'm getting close to being killed. I hope not to do that this time, because in my first one I was killed fairly near the start, actually. These people are having a fight through the wall, proving how well Paint the Town Red works in this current state. Luckily they've given us a couple of good weapons, actually. Can I get the machete? Yes. You're gone. Is anyone else around for me to kill? Yes, a few more people over here. There is this shack of guns that I have been putting off actually visiting because it's kind of overpowered and less fun, but I think I will now. Let's go in and see what's what. Lot of Bibles. Lot of Bibles on top of gun crates, presumably either gun crates, because the next tent over also is full of guns. Yes, here they are. I think one of them actually does have ammo in, so we can use that. Big guy, you're dead. Tough luck, I know. Is anyone... Yes, shotgun, and then this is a full rifle as well. That's another full rifle. Let's use this one. This should be enough for 9 left, right? Right, unless I can't find them, obviously. That would be a bit of a disaster. No one behind here, is there? I couldn't find anyone last time, but I don't think so. Quite an oversight if there was. Sorry if the music's too loud, by the way. I apologise. I don't think it is, but it might be ever so slightly too loud. Back to the church, see if anyone else has snuck back here. No, but this appears to be dripping. That can't be good. Is this a sign of Beelzebub himself arriving? Ah, yes. Is this the campfire I was talking about earlier? No, it's different. Alright, let's see if we can find the thing I was talking about earlier. Because there was a full rifle next to it. And that was what I used primarily for the first part of mine. My first expedition to this level. I see some people fighting over there. That flag appeared to be waving when I was moving side to side, actually. That was kind of cool. Maybe that's intentional, maybe not. Either way, it works. This person's presumably fighting someone else. Yep, another classic redneck living in a... This is terrible. I'd hate to live anywhere near... Within 1,000 miles of this, to be honest. No, not really. It's fine. What about this room? We've been in here already. There's another big game hunting animal on the wall there. Elk, moose of some kind. Anyone over in this quadrant? There's only a couple of people left. You think they'd be fighting each other, but it's a bit hard to tell. I mean, I imagine them to be over here somewhere. Because this is where I've barely explored. Although I have actually killed people here already. Anyone in here? No. I guess I'll cut them when I find them. Yes, now this has certain connotations that I'm not going to get into, but yes. Certainly is there. I found the two people. I was worried I wasn't going to find them. And they are gone. They are doomed, and the swamp is thoroughly painted red. I actually hurt myself there. That would have been a disaster if I did die. I'm not really sure where to leave, but I think I see a glimmer of blue in the distance over there. Oh, there's one here as well. Can I just leave any of the cars? I think I can. I'll take this incredible-looking truck with the collapsible sun headlamps on the top or whatever. We've done it! Secluded Swamp Part 1 is finished. Part 2 will be coming in a later video, don't worry, because this one was good fun. I'm eager to check out the sequel. But anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching this video. All of the map links will be in the description as usual, and if you have any maps you want me to play through, then please leave them in the comments. If you leave a comment with a map, I probably will play through it, just because I know that you're watching my videos and you probably want to see something else. If you did make it to this point as well, thank you very much. I'll definitely check out your map suggestions. So yeah, I'll see you in the next video, guys, and until that time, take care.